Welcome to the training Integrate with SPAPI Step 3B, Connect to SPAPI Manually. This video is designed for developers who want to integrate an application with Selling Partner API. It covers one version of the third step in the integration process, providing step-by-step instructions for connecting to SPAPI manually. Connecting allows developers to call SPAPI and test their authorization workflow. If you prefer to connect to SPAPI using a generated Java SDK, proceed to Step 3A, Connect to SPAPI using a generated Java SDK. We also cover earlier and later steps for SPAPI integration in other videos. And you can find written instructions for each step by searching for the Selling Partner API documentation website. Connecting or calling SPAPI lets you exchange the login with Amazon or LWA refresh token received in Step 2 for an LWA access token. After receiving an access token, you can use it to make one or more calls to SPAPI for up to 1 hour. Use access tokens to make calls while your test authorization workflow is in draft status. When you finish testing, you can then convert your test authorization workflow to a production workflow by listing your application in the Selling Partner App Store. This changes your application status from draft to published. To review the process for converting an authorization workflow and listing an application, refer to the final video in the Integrate with SPAPI series, Step 4, Publish an SPAPI Application. You can also use access tokens to make calls while testing a self-authorization procedure. When you've finished testing a self-authorization procedure, there's no need to convert it to a production workflow. That's because a private application doesn't need to be published. It can remain in draft status. This means developers using a self-authorization procedure don't need to proceed to the final module in this series, but can conclude their training with this Step 3B module. It's worth noting that an LWA access token must be included in calls to all operations unless they're restricted and return personally identifiable information, or PII. When calling a restricted operation, you'll include a restricted data token, or RDT, instead of an LWA access token. For more information, see our video Call Restricted Operations Using Tokens API. To connect and call SPAPI manually, start by requesting an LWA access token in exchange for your refresh token. Make a secure HTTP post to the LWA authentication server with the parameters grant type, refresh token, scope, client ID, and client secret. As a reminder, the LWA authentication server is https://api.amazon.com/auth/02/token. Grant type is the type of access grant you're requesting. Use either the value refresh token or client credentials. Refresh token is the value you received either when the selling partner authorized your application or when you self-authorized in Step 2 of the integration process. Refer to the relevant module in this series for more information. Note that you should only use refresh token if the operation you want to call isn't grantless and requires authorization from a selling partner or requires self-authorization. Use the value client credentials instead of refresh token if the operation you want to call is grantless. For more information about grantless operations, visit the Selling Partner API documentation website. Select Authorizing Selling Partner API Applications from the table of contents, then click Grantless Operations. The next parameter is refresh token. The parameter scope defines the scope of the LWA authorization grant. You can specify one or more values for this parameter. Use Selling Partner API notifications for the Notifications API and Selling Partner API migration for the Authorization API. Note too that scope isn't a required parameter. Only include it if the operation you want to call is grantless. This means that when you include scope, you won't include refresh token in your call and vice versa. The last two parameters, client ID and client secret, are your LWA client identifier and LWA client secret. If you need help retrieving either credential, visit the Selling Partner API documentation website and select Viewing Your Application Information and Credentials from the table of contents. Here's an example secure HTTP post for a call that isn't grantless and requires authorization. And here's an example secure HTTP for a call that is grantless. To avoid getting an untrusted certificate authority error when calling the LWA authorization server, be sure to update your trust store so your application trusts the LWA authorization server. A successful response to your post will include the values access token, token type, expires in, and refresh token. Access token is your LWA access token, which will be no more than 2048 bytes. Token type is the type of token returned, which must be bearer. Expires in is the number of seconds before the LWA access token becomes invalid. This will be 3600 or 1 hour. Here's an example response. If you'd like more information about requesting an LWA access token, search for Login with Amazon, then search for Authorization Code Grant. Once you've received your LWA access token, construct an SPAPI URI with the components HTTP method, endpoint, path, query string, and path parameter. Here's an example component and the final SPAPI URI. With your URI constructed, add the headers host, xAMZ access token, xAMZ date, and user agent. Host is the relevant region endpoint, which is associated with one of three AWS regions: North America, Europe, or Asia Pacific, which is also called APAC. The endpoints for these regions are sellingpartnerapi-na.amazon.com, sellingpartnerapi-eu.amazon.com, and sellingpartnerapi-fe.amazon.com. XAMZ access token is your LWA access token. Remember that if you're calling a restricted operation, you should pass a restricted data token or RDT here instead. XAMZ date is the date and time of your request, and user agent is your application's name and version number, as well as its platform and programming language. Here are example headers. After you've added headers, you'll have connected to SPAPI and completed step 3B of the SPAPI integration process. You can now begin testing your authorization workflow with additional calls to SPAPI. You'll likely test with a trusted selling partner, but you can also test by yourself if you have your own developer credentials. Testing your authorization workflow or self-authorization procedure ensures that your application can exchange parameters with Amazon and receive authorization information. As a reminder, when you've finished testing either a Selling Partner App Store or website authorization workflow, you're ready to move to step 4. When you've finished testing a self-authorization procedure, you've completed the full SPAPI integration process. Thanks for watching.